Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am going to show you a salad recipe that is very hearty. I made it for me and my husband yesterday for lunch. The first ingredient is baby spinach. I took 3 handfuls of baby spinach and split them between 2 bowls. And I like to chop my spinach or greens up in general so that I can fit more in the bowl. According to Dr. Furman, and if you have been watching my videos for any length of time, you know that I really like Dr. Furman. He says that we should aim for about 1 pound of greens every single day. So this makes it easier for me to get my green intake in if I'm not just trying to get it all in a smoothie or in a green juice. But I like to eat salad because what happens is the more I eat it, the more I crave the greens. Next, I'm gonna add an English cucumber. They are my favorite cucumbers. They last a long time in the refrigerator. I typically buy them from Costco and I use them for my salads and for my juices. And I've also been known to add English cucumbers to my smoothies as well. They are really, really good for the skin and they add a crunch to the salad that is really needed, especially if you're trying to get used to eating salad. So I just cut this into 4s and I'm gonna divide the cucumbers between the 2 salads. I realized I can't add the cucumber just yet, so I'm just putting these cucumbers in a bowl and I'm gonna wait until I get the rest of the ingredients in the salad before I add them. Next, I'm gonna add some spring mix. I like it chopped just like the spinach. So I'm gonna chop it and add it to the salad bowl. I added 2 handfuls of the spring mix chopped. And if you are struggling with any type of heavy bleeding or menstrual cycle issues, spring mix is a good addition to your diet. You should try to eat it as often as possible. It will help build your iron. Now it's time for the cucumbers. I'm just going to divide the cucumbers between the 2 salad bowls. The next ingredient is tomatoes. I have some cherry tomatoes here and I have to tell you a little story. I actually used to hate tomatoes, didn't even like tomatoes. And all of a sudden this year, I started eating, well, 2018, I started eating cherry tomatoes and now I can eat them just like candy. Like I just pop them in my mouth for a snack. I don't even know what's wrong with me. I'm like buying cherry tomatoes every time I go shopping and I'm just eating them. I would tolerate them because I knew they were good for me, but I never used to like eating them. So all I'm doing with this particular salad is just cutting them in half and dividing what I had set aside between the 2 bowls. I think I had about maybe a cup and a half of cherry tomatoes, but you can put as many as you want in your salad. Next, we're gonna add blueberries. I believe I have about 1.5 to 2 cups of blueberries and I'm just gonna split them between the 2 bowls. Did you all know that there are omega-3 fatty acids in blueberries? I did not know that, or at least I didn't remember. Next, I'm gonna add some hummus. I got this hummus from Costco. I normally make my hummus from scratch, but I'm going to add a container of hummus to each salad. I had a little bit left in this salsa jar, so I figured I would add it to the salad, give it a little bit of a kick. I think this is a medium salsa. So next is an avocado. This is a medium avocado that I'm cutting in half and I'm going to use 1/4 of the avocado on each salad. I eat low fat, so I'm gonna just score the avocado into little cubes and split the half between the 2 salads. Now for the dressing. Usually what I do is use some type of herb or spice and I squeeze lemon on top of my salad. So that's really what I'm gonna do today. So I'm gonna cut this lemon into quarters, and I'm gonna split a quarter of a lemon for each salad. That's usually enough for me. So along with the lemon, I add seasonings. This seasoning is called Benson's Table Tasty, and it is the zesty variety. I use this stuff on everything. I love it. I'll put a link in the description box below so that you can get this one. It is worth the investment. I buy like a 1 pound bag of it, and it has lasted me. The last one I bought probably has lasted me over a year. Now I'm gonna add some pepper to my salad. Now I'm gonna share with you some salad dressings that I typically use. This is fig vinegar. It's expensive, but it goes a long way. Next is apple cider vinegar. And here's another one. This one is pomegranate vinegar. You get that from Trader Joe's. This is white balsamic vinegar. These are just a few that I use. I also make salad dressings, and I will be sharing a few of those this month, but I'm gonna add hemp seeds to the top of the salad. It's a good way to get your omega-3, so I'm gonna sprinkle about a tablespoon on each salad. Actually, it might even be just a half a tablespoon. It wasn't very much, actually. But there you have it. These are my lunch salads for me and my husband. And if you get into the practice of at least having one big salad every single day, you will start to feel better. Whether you are struggling with women's health issues or you have high blood pressure, diabetes, whatever your health concern is, if you eat a clean salad every day, you will feel better. Okay, y'all, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will talk to you all soon. Take care. God bless.